17, I believe.
Okay.
And I've seen, and you know, Raichu against Alvin too. Like he kept it that close in the Ness versus Pikachu matchup. So his Pikachu is almost developed just for the intention against Kirby.
Okay.
And
it's his namesake, you know. It's Raichu.
Oh yeah.
So you gotta have a good Pika. Played Risner yesterday, and you played him today. So
I did.
We kind of know what he looks for. Ooh, Raichu starting off strong. I see that running plat drop.
Like Ray, I would say Risner's pretty sneaky with a lot of his play. Like you kind of find out what he's going for pretty quickly, but he's just good at what he's looking for. Doesn't really put any fluff in it. Keeps it simple. I think generally he would be better against fast hauler characters, but we're gonna see how the simplicity works against like a Pikachu of Raichu's caliber. Right now, doing pretty well here. Kind of gets the read there on that up B, but not quite. But still zoning out pretty well. Raichu not really able to get in, as I say that.
Nice.
Good conversion.
Standard stuff from Raichu, but exactly what you need in this matchup. Send Kirby off the stage. Ooh, doesn't find it there.
Yeah, interesting recovery, but it pays off. And the tech in was interesting. If he was under top flat, a grab would have killed there. But instead, Raichu just turns it around. Quick 4-2 lead.
Risner likes his like down air traps into like forward smashes. So yeah, he's pretty forward smash heavy. And I can't tell if that's a new school thing or an old school thing, because I have seen a lot of Kirby's doing it recently, but it could be one of those things that's like an old trend that comes back because it fell out of style and now it's good again. But it is a really good move. It's underrated Kirby move. Kills many characters at very low percent, and down air puts you in this tech trap situation where if Kirby gets that read, it could be deadly.
Oh, and interesting up B, but it pays out. Pays off there. And you know, Risner trying to keep it competitive here. Raichu just seems more than prepared though. Ooh. Oh wow. Thought he was risking it all there, but not really much risk at all from Raichu's end.
That's Pika for you.
Oh yeah. We'll see how Raichu edgeguards here. Probably trying to close it out. The up air should do it.
He keeps dropping these though.
He just wants some more. Risner's still living. Good up B escape there.
This is such a bad spot for Kirby.
Yeah, especially at this percent.
Yeah.
At lower percents, you can kind of afford trades here and there. But anything will touch you and
you're done.
You're dead, you know?
Yeah.
You kind of need those jumps.
Yeah. Definitely need those jumps.
So it looked like Raichu just had a free time getting in. I believe, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, he was pretty aggressive and it paid off.
Yeah, it didn't really look like he gave Risner much space to do what he wants to do. But he switched to Ness. So, trying to keep it a little interesting.
He knew that, I mean, his Pika won very solidly, so he can kind of afford to show off his Ness. His Ness is really cool. I played it online a couple times, and it has a lot of tricks. And
oh, yeah.
He always likes to come out and prove that it's not just online stuff. He can do it on console.
Mm-hmm.
But he's very, very smart. He has lots of setups on the platforms and little traps and baits. And
yeah,
super good.
I think his fundamentals are incredible, but he likes to spice it up a little bit with, like, it's kind of those quirky little Ness things. Like, Bat isn't the forward smash isn't a move that you would expect to be used much, but he just likes to throw it out every now and then. Risner should have an easier time edgeguarding Ness than Pikachu.
Right. Fast falls that bear.
Away, though.
Yeah. He got a little hungry there. He didn't need to go that hard. I mean,
yeah.
You don't even always have to go out there versus Ness. You can afford to let him come back up and then just edgeguard him again. And rinse and repeat kind of thing.
Kirby having that down tilt that has a semi-spike angle. And
some disjoint on it, too.
Oh, yeah. Like, that's usually just about all you need to tap Ness and put him in the grave.
I don't know if it's true, but people say that Ness down air is like the most hit stun in the game. It's definitely up there. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, I don't. If anything competes, maybe Yoshi forward air off the ground, you know?
Yeah, Yoshi forward air does have a lot.
But
that initial Kirby upbeat hit has a lot too.
Oh yeah, that fixed knockback on top of that.
So Raichu making it a quick one, even quicker than the Pika. Really, it's only been a minute.
Yeah, Raichu just, I think he really likes these matchups where the opponent might not be defending themselves too much and he can just really go in and start his combos.
Yeah.
And that's what Ness loves. I think even though Ness is generally a worse character than what we normally see, his punish game is among the best.
And again, it all comes down to this character is bad, but how well does my opponent know the matchup?
Oh, and he drops the pants on him. That was a great stall there.
Poor throw, we'll close it out. Very strong throws from Ness.